Hello, I am Test Drive, and welcome to another episode of Gran Turismo 5. Where in this episode, we are going to continue on with A-Spec, and it took me literally forever to figure out what I wanted to do and which car I wanted to use. So, I'm pleased to tell you that we will be using a Miata already. This is very similar to Forza 4, except for, you know, this Miata is actually an NV instead of an NA like the Forza 4 one. So we're going to buy this Mazda Miata 1800 RS. Yep. And we are going to be doing the World Compact Car Challenge, which I really want to keep this, even though you can use like any car in this race, I want to keep it like, oh, it wants me to use a compact car, so I'm going to use a compact car. Which a Miata is pretty much a compact car. It's a very small car. Especially after now I've driven one in real life. I know now it's truly a small car. So we're just going to use it. We're not even going to upgrade it or anything yet. I might have to upgrade soon though. I think I'm going to do the Yaris race next with the one I won in the last episode, and I think I need a turbo to win that one if I remember right, but we'll see. So I'm gonna go back to beginner series, and we're going to be doing the World Compact Car Race, which is a championship for the first time ever in this series so far. I forgot to show off all the crap again, but oh well. So it appears that we're actually like up against like really really small cars, a Mini One, which is like the very first Mini Cooper made by BMW. Huh, oh well. I don't feel bad about picking a Miata. It's a small car. It's a compact, with air quotes. So we're gonna race it anyways. And of course this one is a oh, I forgot to do the oil change. Oh shit, what up? And I forgot to change. I'm gonna be right back. Okay, so let's try this again. Since we have bought a used car with some miles on it, it needs an oil change. All the used cars, whenever you first buy them, need an oil change, and could use a wash as well, which will improve the performance of the car, oddly enough. Yeah, all this stuff. Whoop-de-doodly-doo, welcome to GT Auto. And this is also where you can, like, paint your wheels, paint the car, change the wheels, which you can do on standard cars. Aero kits, which there are actually some for standard cars. Do an engine overhaul. Chassis maintenance, which will like make it handle better or be more powerful, which doesn't really do much. And it's really, really expensive. Or you could race modify the car if it has the race modification, which most cars do not. I think 17 cars do total. But they have these funny little animations. They're very cheap, like the car washes and crap. As you can tell, it's kind of a funny little thing. I guess the top is not need to be washed. Like, all these GT Auto things are pretty funny. So, we have a car wash, which I think does something, I think. I don't really know. I know it does in Gran Turismo 6, because your cars in GT 6 actually get dirty, and they stay dirty. So, we're also going to do an oil change, because you can tell my oil is crappy. But, it's kind of funny, because it's like, the only reason that's in there is that whenever you buy used cars, like, there's... unless you just grind one race with one car, like... more than enough times, you're not going to need to oil change a car again, or oil change a new premium car. So that's all we're going to do for now. I'll show you 11 grand to do chassis maintenance and 6,500 to do the engine overhaul, which I think that's actually that's relative to the price of the car or how much the car is worth. So it's going to be like hundreds of thousands of dollars to do it on like race cars and crap. Which is why I never really do it. But I do have coupons, because why not? And I guess I'll show this. Entry requirements are no limitations, as I mentioned. I just wanted to actually keep true to the compact part. There's all the cars I could be racing against, which you've already seen some of them, which I probably will be racing against again. And of course, the garage. And yada, yada, yada. And we're going to city tracks this time. And Cape Ring, which isn't a city track. Yeah, so the car list is actually a little bit different this time around. Instead of a bunch of Mini Coopers, we have... I was going to buy the Lupo GTI for this. I actually was, but I decided against it. But it probably would have been competitive still. And it would be different too, because everybody uses Miatas. Like, why use a Miata when you could use a freaking Polo GTI? And it's actually kind of a neat looking little car too. So yeah, let's get into this. So this isn't a standard car interior, as I was going to mention before I realized I was stupid. And... oh, all the assists are probably on still because I didn't change them. Yep, they are. You know what? I'll change them before the next race. I don't care enough to restart again. I don't want to look at that, do we? We want to look at this. Drafting works really good in this game. Way better than it actually should. There is damage in this game, but it only really works if you're a high level and you really get smacked. And it's not really any kind of damage other than, like, just mucking up the body a little bit, like denting in the fender. That's really all the damage it entails to. Ow, there's a Polo GTI. Oh, the screen tearing, I saw it. There's a Del Sol in front of me, look at that. I think I have the, well, I don't know, that MG might be, it probably is rear-wheel drive. Yeah, Del Sol. And a MG of some sort, which we didn't get MGs here in the US after like 1975 or something, and all that we got then was like the MGB, and that was it. So that's, I've never seen an MG like that before in person, or really anywhere except for in this game. Oh, look at that pro braking. Well, pro-ish. Come on. Oh, he slowed down. Ha! I am the winner. Also, you can get some funny names in this game, which I will probably show off later. Oh, I just realized I could have showed off a thing, but I haven't yet. That's hilarious. I'll probably do that, I don't know. I might do it at the beginning of an episode or the end of an episode sometime. Yeah, something that happened on my other profile relating to names that some people probably know. Yeah, Miata. It's a Miata. I mean, it feels like a Miata, kind of. Also, this camera... I wish the outside camera view was better, but it's, like, attached to the car, and it doesn't move at all. Like, I don't like it when it moves too much. Like, in Need for Speed, the action camera, whatever, the new Need for Speed game, I can't stand that. But, like, when it's completely just straight onto the back of the car 100% of the time, it also gets weird. Third lap. I can't wait until we start getting, like, rain races and snowy races and crap like that. Those are the fun ones. It's funny because the traction control actually isn't really doing much in this. This car does not have enough power to actually really spin the rear wheels that much besides on launch. Although this one does have like 160 horsepower because it's like the 1800 RS or whatever kind of crap that is. Instead of having like 130 horsepower, it's like 160. So... that's nice. And I'm winning by a lot. Oops. Car behind is 1.6 seconds behind, which isn't actually that bad. Car doesn't... the game does not want me to drift. It's throwing all of the stops at me. AKA traction control. Or stability control, whichever one that would be. I think it's traction control because there is no stability control in this game. And I'm going to be the winner chicken dinner here in a second. Yay! So, now that we finished that, it will give me points of some sort after we watch this. The Colt. Dodge Colt. Not really. 12 seconds behind. So, it will give me some credits, as you can tell. And I have points, and I have experience. I get to level 3. Cool! I probably unlocked something. But yeah, so it gives you points. You can see the differences there. I'm not going to like say all of them, of course. You can suspend the race, which I think just sends you out to the main menu. And if you want to race again, you have to like finish this. Or you can retire like I did before. Or you can watch a replay. Simple as that. Okay, so we are now here on oh my god. The game is having a slight problem loading everything in. It loaded too quickly. It's still not loaded in all the way. I don't think. Maybe, I don't know. It looks kind of shitty. Oh, wait. No. Oh, I didn't change the assist. I remembered it as soon as I hit the X button, of course. Well, god dang it. Because you can't end the race or else it's going to be like, oh, you have to go to the next race now. You forfeited. Oh, well. I can live with traction control. It's whatever. I think traction control is really the only one that actually changes between cars. Or, like, resets whenever you pick a different car. Also, is it going to do the thing where it's like, all of a sudden it's like, yeah, it's like Forza Horizon 3. Just suddenly go. Be prepared with your foot on the throttle. Speaking of foot on the throttle, why am I not using my wheel for this? Because I didn't feel like setting it up and I'm lazy. If you were asking that question, that is why. I would, because this game actually works really well with the wheel. But I also really want to get new parts for my wheel before I really use it that much more, because A, it's tearing my desk apart, so I need a wheel stand, and B, my pedals work a quarter of the time, so I definitely need new ones, but I don't have the money to replace them right now with better ones, so we're kind of stuck with what we are. I see things popping in the distance as well. Aha! This turn sucks. I somehow didn't hit a wall, though. And somehow I'm already in first. I'm sorry, I'm not trying to be overpowered. I'm kind of curious what car I'll get from this. I think you actually get the Audi Bianchi A112 Abarth, which is probably a really foreign name to people who are American and have never played this game. I didn't know what it was until I got it. I remember that's a prize car for something, but I can't remember what. Because I remember flaunting it out on GT Planet forums whenever I was part of that. Which, fun fact, yes, I was part of GT Planet and ForzaMotorsport.net forums for a long time. Like, when this game came out, I was on there all day, every day. Just on the forums. Because I wanted to see the game. It also kind of ruined the game. Well, it didn't really ruin the game for me, but it ruined, like, the surprise of, like, cars and crap. Even though, like, working at a classic car dealership and seeing all the kinds of different cars has, like, really taught me how interesting different cars are. Like, before I was just like, okay, whatever, there's a stupid Nissan Cube or whatever. And now I'm like, huh, the Nissan Cube, that's kind of neat. And it's also taught me, like, oh, there's an Alfa Romeo Duetto, like in the first episode in the used car dealership. I would have not cared about that car whatsoever had I not worked at a classic car dealership for a year and a half now. So it's kind of interesting. It really changes your perspective on things whenever you work around a lot of different cars all the time. And then you're like, and then I'm like going over random facts that nobody even cares about in my head as I'm seeing these certain cars like the Duetto. It's just kind of funny. So I like how they kept the soft tops on all the Miatas in this game. None of them have hard tops. At all. Actually, I don't know, the NC might. AKA the 2007 or whatever. This game doesn't look bad for being 7 years old, like I said, and most of the cars don't look too bad for being ported from a game from 2005 on PS2 hardware. And for me, it's mostly, like, I don't really care about how the car looks, I just care about, like, the fact that the car is in the game. Such as the NB Miata or whatever, which is 20... I think there's like 25 Miatas overall. But just having the selection of cars is like my favorite thing. I could care less about how they look. I just care about how they drive. And just the fact that they're there. Oh my god, the Demio and the Colt are so slow. 17 and 14 seconds behind. Jesus. Huh. Get some more money. Hey, I leveled up again. And we will get a nice little bonus at the end of the last race, too. Like, money and XP-wise. As well as a car, probably. Well, actually, we will get a car. Also, the game's, like, loading really fast. It's loading faster than it can load, if that makes sense. Because it keeps, like... Well, at least in the last track, it was that weird glitch where it was like, oh, there's nothing here yet. Oh, there it is. There it is. It just starts to pop in. And I gotta wait for... to pop up, and I'm going to change my settings now. What's settings? What's under settings? Oh, that's where you can upgrade your car. Okay, never mind. I'll look at that later. Like I said, so we're gonna go to driving options and turn off the traction control for just the last race. Yeah, you can like adjust controller steering sensitivity, active steering, stability management, yada yada yada, simple stuff. So let's get going. So many hatchbacks, and I'm in a convertible. At least I don't feel out of place completely, because there's the MG, which is a white convertible with a black top. It's kind of funny that they selected that color for that car. Oh, yes, and this is Capering. Welcome to Capering. One pain in the ass of a track. Also, there's a premium car in front of me, because I can see through the windows easily. That's how you know it's a premium car from outside. As well as a Lupo. Oh yeah, that's the Lupo that I was talking about earlier that I wanted to buy. I would have bought if I wouldn't have bought this Miata. And I still kind of want it. But it's not going to be in the used car dealership by the time I get done with this, so I can't buy it anyways. Plus, I think I'm not going to have enough money to buy a new car next episode as well. So I'm going to have to probably do the Vitz race or Yaris race or whatever it's called. Because I already have one of those. And thus why I didn't want to use it for the front wheel drive crap or anything like that. Hey, my car is a bruise. So yeah, once you get like level 30 or so, the damage gets pretty intense. Like how it looks, because that's all it affects is how the car looks. But for right now, it's just kind of like, there's a little bit of scratch on the front of the car. That's about it. I really like the MB Miata. I'm like one of those people that, I don't know, I almost like the MB Miata more than the NA. Although I do like pop-up headlights, the MB just is interesting and cool and different. Because you see NA Miatas everywhere, you don't see a lot of MB Miatas. And they're also not as cheap as the NAs, which kind of sucks, but... Hey, what can you do about a 10-year newer car? Oh, can I make this? The game says I can. Oh! Yeah, the flashing numbers next to the, or like right by the tachometer, or actually I think it's the left of the gear. That's the game telling you which gear you should be in a corner. You can't really turn it off unless you turn the speedometer off. So yeah. I generally don't pay attention to it that much, although I think I do in reality because I kind of see it and I look at it and I look back up. But I don't generally like, oh, I should definitely shift down to this gear or like freak out about it. It's just like something that happens. I don't know, it's weird. Manzano, Lowry, Iwasaki, Matsumura, Furman. That sounds like German. Is it Germans? Oh, God. R. Huff. I thought it said H. Ruff at first. I was like, what? And then Piroho. I'm going to laugh if somebody's like, oh, you don't know so-and-so's name is like that and so-and-so racing. I'm like, what? I don't care. I really don't care about names. I know the ones I know, and that's it. I could care less about others at the moment. The Aztrek is pretty interesting too, whenever you get like the full version. It's got like a loop-de-loop section where it's just like a perfect circle and you go up a level, so it's like you go around in a circle twice. I just ran out the road. I am good at the game. The car doesn't really get dirty in this game like it does in GT6 whenever you go off the road. But the tires, like, get dirty and crap. Again, little features, like the tires getting dirty whenever you're off the road. Something that Forza doesn't have, or didn't have. I think they have it now in Forza 6 and crap. Okay. Maybe that was the last race, too. So we'll go see if there's anything interesting in the car dealership real quick. And we got credits. We got XP. Doesn't it give you a credit and XP bonus? I thought it did. Yay, I got first in the world classic. Oh yeah, there we go. Ooh, I am gonna have money. I'm gonna have a... I have almost the exact same amount of money that I had before. I have like 300 credits more. Oh, it doesn't give you XP, okay. So it gives you money, but not XP whenever you finish championships. So, let's see. Pretty sure we won an Auto Bianchi, or Auto Bianchi, or however the hell you say it. Let us see what we have. Reach level 4, so we have the Top Gear test track races, which can be annoying. They're interesting though. Oh, what the hell is the brand on that thing? Some weird brand. It's French, I think. But it's that thing, the Berlinette RS Coupe. Yeah, I guess before that, I can show you like my garage. As you can tell, we have the 86 GT, we got a kart because of the kart races being unlocked. And then we also got our Toyota Vitz U Euro Sport Edition. Which, like I said, I might have to put a turbo on it to win the Yaris Vitz whatever races. But that won't be a big deal. Plus, we'll be able to show upgrading. So I'll grab that car after, in between episodes, and I'll try and actually remember to show it at the beginning of the next episode. But let's see what we got. Oh, we got another Polo GTI, but it's got higher miles. An Alteza AS200. Oh, yeah, that's what they call them. 2000 Camaro SS. I remember I used to be obsessed with getting the 97 Camaro Z28 in this game. Because it was like the steel beam headlight one. So I was like, oh my god, I have to have it. Focus ST170, which is a neat car. Actually, nice car too. The RX7. An R8 Audi race car. Nice. First Gen Insight. Citroen 2CV. S2K. A Celica Supra. Corvette Coupe. Another Miata. Ooh, an IS300 wagon. Forgot that was in this game. Huh. A newer Sprinter Treno. Not an A86, but the one after it, like the 98. Lotus Esprit V8 SC, which are fun as hell to drive. Oh, it's not in black, so it's not like the one I drove. RX-7, a Z32, a last year Z32. Actually, I think it's last year. 3000 GT VR4, which I can't buy. A Celica, which I could buy. Another Vitz, an Impreza. A Roof CTR2, because there's no Porsche in this game, so you have Roof, or Rough, however the fuck you say it. And then back to cars. Okay, so it's like, would it be five races then? Because I got in one, I had to back out because I forgot to change settings. And I did the three, so it'd be four. So yeah, it'd be five different races to completely change out the used car dealership. So I'm going to dick around for a little bit in between episodes, figure out what car I want to use for whatever race next. But thank you guys for watching this episode, and I'm out of here. See ya.